Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today, we'll be discussing the management of a wide complex tachycardia. So, a 50-year-old male was brought to ER. He had complaints of some chest pain about 1 hour back, and right now he was asymptomatic. But in view of the chest pain, he came to the ER. Initial 10-second assessment, the patient was conscious-oriented. Coming to the primary survey, the patient's airway was patent. There was no signs of airway compromise. Breathing, he had adequate chest movements. Saturation was 99% in room air. And coming to circulation, he had a heart rate of 200 beats per minute. And his BP was 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury. So he was connected to a cardiac monitor. And two large bore IV cannulas were secured at this time.
Two large bore IV cannulas secured.
Cardiac monitors connected.
So cardiac monitors were connected and it was showing a wide complex tachycardia. And it was like a wide monomorphic tachycardia. So we have to get a 12-lead ECG by this time. And also we can get a blood gas analysis to look for any other causes, reversible causes for this tachycardia. Since it's a wide complex tachycardia and the patient was stable, that is, there was no signs of any hypotension, shock, heart failure, no chest pain currently, and there was no altered mentation, we can go with the pharmacological management. So we can give injection amiodarone 150 mg IV over 10 minutes. So please administer injection amiodarone 150 mg IV, and it should be administered over 10 minutes. If it was regular and monomorphic wide complex tachycardia, that's a monomorphic wide complex tachycardia, we can also give a trial of adenosine, but we had given injection amiodarone.
Injection amiodarone 150 mg
given. So it should be given over 10 minutes, and we have to check for the response. So the rhythm was getting converted to a sinus rhythm. It's a sinus tachycardia, and again we are getting wide complex tachycardia, and we have to again check for the primary survey. So the patient's airway was patent, breathing was okay, saturation was maintained, but his in circulation his blood pressure had come down. So BP was 80 by 50 millimeters of mercury, which is a sign of instability, and so we'll have to go for the DC synchronized cardioversion. So since it is a wide complex tachycardia, we have to go for a cardioversion with 100 joules. And for the DC cardioversion, we have to get the consent, we have to get the crash cut arranged, and we have to adequately sedate the patient and give analgesic. After explaining the procedure to the patient, we can go ahead with the DC cardioversion. So Dr. Manna, you can go ahead with the DC cardioversion.
So since it is a wide complex regular tachycardia, I will be selecting 100 joules. I will press on to the sync button.
Synchronized cardio version.
Conductive jellies played. Patient has already been explained about the procedure and is being sedated. Then I will press on to the charge button. All clear. And I will keep it for 10 seconds so that the shock is delivered.
So while we are changing the mode to the synchronized cardio version, we will see at the peak of the QRS complex, that's at the peak of the RV, we'll get the synchronized lines will be there, and we have to give the shock and wait for 10 seconds, then only we'll have to remove the paddles. So after DC version, we have to check for the response. So the rhythm was getting converted to a sinus rhythm, and with a heart rate of 120 per minute, and the patient should be reassessed. So his there was no signs of airway compromise, his breathing was normal, and the circulation part, his BP had improved to 100 by 60 millimeters of mercury. And this is how we manage a wide complex tachycardia according to the ACLS guideline. Initially we have tried for the pharmacological management with amiodarone, the rhythm reverted, but again the wide complex tachycardia recurred, and the patient went into the unstable category of wide complex tachycardia. So we go ahead with the synchronized DC cardioversion, and the patient was reverted to a sinus rhythm. Thank you.